Forum Chadha joining in with us on the technicals now. Forum, very good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining in with us. And Forum, let's start with your first talk that you have picked out for us today. And when you talk about it, it's BPCL. What's the view on BPCL? Where do you see this in terms of a target price?
Hi, good afternoon, and thank you for having me on the show. Well, to begin with, BPCL, like from the lows of 445 this year, the stock has seen a stellar run. It's moved up to nearly 687. That is nearly 50% rise in probably just 1.5 to 2 months. So that's a very good move as far as BPCL as a stock is concerned. However, after peaking out at 687, that is in the month of Feb, we've seen a corrective decline, but this decline has been nearly 50% of its entire move of what we've seen. From 445 to 687. So 50% is more like a Fibonacci retracement as per the technicals, and it coincided by taking support at a 50-day moving average. And thereafter, we've seen a very good consolidation. So this consolidation is again a good level to accumulate or invest from a longer-term perspective. Today, again, we have seen that the stock price has now come down by around 2%, along with the Nifty also coming down. So it's giving a good opportunity to consider investing in small tranches, consider buying 20-25% at current levels and keep adding it to the level of around 598 to 600, which is a support level. And any price below the levels of closer to around 580 can be considered to move out. Whereas on the higher side, I'm expecting a target of closer to around 685 to around 690.
Arrow Green Tech, what's the view on this one? This is the first time you're talking about it on the channel at least.
Yes, absolutely. I think it's been the first time that I'm sharing this recommendation here. Now, when this stock, as far as the stock is concerned, that since last October, the stock was facing a very strong resistance near these levels of 590-595, and it was just hovering on the lower side. It was at 400 levels. So for a long phase, that it just remained in a very deep consolidation. And now we have seen that last month, it made a very good breakout. It, in fact, that day it had closed up by around 40-odd%. And since then, we're seeing a bit of a retracement. We've seen the markets coming down along with this. The stock is also coming down. But this stock is trying to take support near those breakout levels of around 490-495, which also ideally becomes a good level to buy or invest. Again, today the stock is spiked up by around 4-4.5%. However, I would just suggest that wait for a lower level of closer to around 500-510 from an investment perspective to buy. As far as volumes are concerned, very good increase in volume, which is supporting the bullishness. So even from a near intermediate term or a long term, it's a good buy at these levels. And stop loss should be maintained below the levels of around 470. And one can look for a higher target of 600 and then closer to 630.
Let's talk about ICICI Bank and how is this one looking to you on the charts? Do you think a formidable player amongst the private sector banking stocks right now?
Well, absolutely. Now, when we have to compare it to the Bank Nifty had gained nearly 7-odd% from its April lows of 46,500 to nearly 49,900-odd levels. After that, we saw a good retracement in the Bank Nifty. So similarly, even in the ICICI Bank stock, we have seen the stock price rising from around 1,050 to closer to around 1,069, which is nearly around 11-odd%. We've seen it retracing nearly 60-61% from its entire up move closer to around a level of 1,100-odd levels. So this is acting as a very good support level and an opportunity to retesting these levels. So some who do not have it in their portfolio can consider keeping it as a part of the portfolio as an investment. It's a good opportunity to buy because after a very recent rally, to see a bit of a retracement and gives an opportunity to buy when the overall trend of the stock is bullish. So I am bullish on the stock. One can consider buying around 25-30% at current levels. Add on more at near these levels of around 1,090. Strict stop loss should be placed below the levels of around 1,080, and one can look for initial upside target of its previous highs of 1,170. And post that, they can look for a higher target of closer to 1,190.
All right. Welcome back. You're watching Market for Tafford. Let's talk about Crompton then Forum. And how is this one looking on the charts to you?
Well, rumor. Now, speaking from since March 2023, the stock was in a very broad consolidation. It was in a consolidation phase. The range on the lower side was 260, on the higher side 320. So it was in this 20-25% of this range. Now, finally, we are seeing a good breakout, which came at the beginning of this month at these levels of 320. And it witnessed some good upside momentum towards 340-342 levels. And the stock price has now been retesting, or I would say it's consolidating in that zone of near the breakout levels. So current price is around 336. And from an investment perspective, those who have it can continue to hold on to it for a higher target of closer to 400 with a 1 year time horizon. Whereas people who do not have it and are looking to get into the stock can wait for a lower level of closer to around 325 to 330 to enter into the stock from an investment perspective. And as far as stop loss is concerned, one should maintain a strict stop loss below the levels of around 310.
Okay, keeping an eye on those levels over there for Crompton, let's move on and talk about